Hello everyone, welcome to part 210 of Advanced Ecom series in Laravel 8. So we are going to continue working on the return process once again. In the last video, we have seen that we able to create the table, the return request table with all the columns, with all the required columns. And there is one change we want to do here. Instead of product ID, we want the product size. Okay, so product size is required instead of product ID, so we can make the change here itself, okay, to save the time. Otherwise you can do this change in your migration file and then create the migration, then create the table, or you can use the update migration query. Okay, product side varchar 255, that is fine, and we are going to replace its value as well. Okay, so now see its product size, that is fine, and we can make it small. Okay, see, this change is required in return request table. Sometime it happens that we have created something, but when we will move further, we may require to make the changes in the earlier steps as well. Okay, so this is the change. Do this at your end, and if you want to do in migration file, then you can also do in your migration file as well. Okay, create return request here. See, instead of product ID, just make it product size, and here instead of integer, make it string. Okay, and that is fine. And also you can make the change in the cedar file of the return request. Okay, return request cedar file here as well. Instead of product ID, we are having here product size. Okay, and here instead of one, we are having here small. Okay, then you can just delete the table, and you need to run that php artisan migrate command once again. And if any issue will come, then you can also remove one last column from the migration file, like this one. See, this one you need to delete, and it will get created again with the right columns. Okay, so this is one of the way, but I'm not going to do it. Will take 5-10 minutes because we don't have that much time, but you can do at your end if you want. Otherwise you can simply update the table like this, like we have created. And just turn sizes or kind of. Okay, so here instead of cancel order, return order will come. Okay, and it will only come whenever the status of the order will be converted to delivered. Like this is the new status. After that, it will get converted to something in process. Okay, in process will update. See, this status shipping partner going to update automatically in our e-commerce website. You are not required to do anything. And for that, please follow API series, Laravel API series. Because if you will not follow that series, you will not going to know that how to process the orders. Because nowadays, no one manually process the orders. All the clients require to integrate some kind of shipping partner. Okay, if we will talk about 10 years back, then people used to update manually. Okay, so you need to know how to integrate the shipping partner. We have already integrated the shipping partner for our Laravel e-commerce website, live shipping partner, where the orders get processed. Okay, so that is mandatory. Okay, so now see, here manually we are doing. So see, we need to update the final status, is it delivered. So once the order status update to delivered, then only here return order will come, same like Amazon. We have seen in this step in Amazon. See, once the order will get delivered, then here we need to show the return order. So let's open the order details file, order details here in front, and here we are going to open the cancel order. We see here it is. So like we have shown the cancel order, in the same way we are going to show here the return order as well. Okay, so we will add one more condition here. When the order status is delivered, then in that case we are going to show return order link, return order, and see see here model also we are going to open the model for the return order for the return step similar to the Amazon, but here we need to make the changes like example model. So we need to make the changes in the cancel order as well, and like here we will mention the cancel order, and here we can mention the return model. Okay, so let me do for all like this. See here I'm going to make it cancel model label and cancel model. Okay, so here I will come back and here I'm going to make it a return model. Now it seems to be fine. Okay, so see here it is the cancel model and it is the return model. Now it is more clear because we can't use the same model ID. Okay, so now we need to open the return model. First of all, we are going to check that whether the return order link, so it has come up, that is fine. So now we need to create this return model similar to the cancel model that we have created earlier. So this one I'm going to copy this model. Okay, and here we can also mention that it is the cancel model. Okay, and now we are going to work on the return model. Okay, so see, if you have directly come to this return process video, then please follow the cancel process as well, because many things we are going to take from the cancel process, many things are similar, so we are not going to do from scratch. Okay, like this model we have picked from the same model, just we are going to make this some changes. Okay, so here you can see instead of cancel model, here we require to make it return. Okay, so everywhere we can make the return here. So we can do one thing like this. Okay, so yeah, fine. So here we are going to make the return model everywhere. Okay, so here as well, return model, this one we missed. Now fine, now you can see this is the return model, and here the link will go to return slash return instead of slash cancel. This route we are going to create in next step, but first of all we are going to create the form for the return. Here it will come reason for return. Okay, reason for return. Okay, so here the reasons will come. So the reasons we have already seen in Amazon, we are going to add those kind of reasons that are there in Amazon. Okay, so some of the reason are like performance or quality not adequate. Okay, so here we are going to add the similar reason that we have seen in Amazon. Okay, see, we can remove all other one by one. We are going to add select reason performance or quality not adequate. Okay, fine. So there is another reason there we have seen, like product damaged means product is damaged, but shipping box okay. So this is the another reason that we have seen in Amazon. If you have ever done some return in Amazon, then you are going to check. Okay, in the last video we have seen all these reasons, and there is another reason like item arrived too late. So this is another reason that we have seen there. So most of the websites are having such kind of reason for the return, and most of the website have the return process now to make the website more give more comfort to the user. So here wrong item was sent. Okay, now the another reason like item defective or does not work. I think that much is fine for the testing purpose. Okay, more you can add of your own if you want. So these are the reasons for the return, but one thing we are missing here, here also we are required to the return. See, here we required to add the product. We are required to select the product first, okay? Only then this reason will come. Okay, so here refresh once and check that this model is opening. See, reason for return. So that is fine, the reasons are coming here. But suppose if there are two products, then we are going to select one of the products. So let's place one order with the two products. Okay, first of all, let's place one order with the two products so that user is going to return one of the product. Okay, so that case we need also need to consider that case in which user is going to return one of the product out of two. See, there are two products here. One is the red casual t-shirt and one is the blue casual t-shirt, and user is going to place the order for the two t-shirts but going to return one of the t-shirt. Okay, so I'm going to place the order for this one. So now see, I'm going to check this order in admin panel. I'm going to convert the status. See, first the status will convert to in process once you are going to process the order. And if you, even if you are doing the manual updates and now you are going to ship that order, then you are going to convert the status to the ship with the courier name and the tracking number. Like if you will go to the courier partner, you see that the courier partner is FedEx and its number is something like this one. Then you are going to update this like this. Okay, then it is get shipped. And you will keep tracking the order manually. Okay, you will say that this order has been shipped. Then you will convert the status to delivered. Once everything is done, then you will update the status to the delivered. Okay, so this is the final status. You will check the order has been delivered to the customer. Then you will update the status to delivered. So once the status has been delivered to the customer, then you will see in my account in order section, you are going to see the customer will have the return order tab activated. Okay, so once you will click on return order, these reasons will come, and here you can see there are two items that the user have purchased for. So we need to give the return for every item. User may return this one or this one or maybe both, but at one time user can only return one item. Okay, so only the return request user can able to make, but the admin, the client will decide whether their request will approve or get rejected. Same thing happen in Amazon and other big brands. See, return, your return will not get approved instantly. It will get approved after some time whenever the client will get satisfied with your reason. Okay, so here once we will click on return order, we need to show both the items here. There are many ways to show the items. We can show in radio button or we can show in drop down, but we will show in drop down to fasten up the process. But you can show the radio button with images as well. Okay, it's your choice, but the process will remain the same. Okay, so let's create one more model body here to add that select that option tab for the selecting for products. Okay, so we are going to add here div class the same model body. Okay, like this. Inside this we are going to add here select. Okay, and in select we will give the name to this select, like name is the product product info. Okay, so ID we can keep it like a return product. This is the ID we will have here. So it's not required. So this one we will add the jQuery for it, okay? And option, now we are going to add the option here. Option is, the value is empty here, and we will add the select product here. Okay, so we will show both the products here. We will show the product code and size here, okay? So we are going to pick this, we are going to open the from where we are fetching the order details. So this is the, I think, user controller at front, and this one, see it is here or not, I'm not sure. Otherwise we can just check it from where this page is opening in routes. Okay, so this one is the admin route. We need to pick the front route. This is the orders controller order details. Okay, orders controller at front inside this order details. See, we can check like this when we not remember that we have, where we have created the function. So this is the order products coming in order details. So we need to add the for each loop here to get all items here. Okay, here we will add the for each loop order details, and inside that we are having that order products like this. Okay, orders products, I think it's orders products like this. Then here we're going to have as dollar product. Now inside this we will have the options for the ordered products. Okay, option value is we are going to have now two values here. One is the product code and another one is the size. One is the product code okay, and another one is the size, product size. Here we are going to have the product size. So same we are going to add here in option value as well as here. Okay, now we are going to check once that whether we are having both the products in drop down. So now click on return order, and here you can see both the products are there, BT01 medium product and RC01. This is for blue t-shirt medium size, red t-shirt medium size. Okay, and reasons are also coming up. One more we are required to show the comment as well. We have the comment field as well. Okay, so comment we can make optional as well. Okay, so it's our choice. So one more field we are going to add here. So we are going to add one more to show the comments. Model body. Okay, so here we are going to show the test area. Okay, so in test area we are going to show name comment and placeholder is also comment like this. Okay, now we can check once. Now all three must be there, like select product, select reason and comment. So that is fine. So we can make a few more changes here, like here the model is too big. We are not required that much big model now, so we can do one thing here. We can create the style here. We can give the width to the model, 350 pixel is enough. And also we can align the model, like we can align the model to the center, okay, like this. Now we are going to check once again, see return orders. Now it seems to be fine. Reason for return, select product, select reason and comment. Okay, if you want to make it more big, you can give it 380 also. See, now this one also you can move to the center if required, otherwise it is fine here. Okay, close and return order. Okay, so now you can see it is seems to be fine. Okay, so now we also require to add the jQuery for this one, for the return model, like we have given for the cancel. Okay, for the cancel option we are already having this one, so similar to that we will also give the option for the return order as well to check for the validation return order. So here instead of button cancel order, we will have that button return order. On the click of that button, we will pick the return reason. Okay, and see, please select a reason for here we are going to have that we will write something like please select reason for returning the order. Returning the order, okay, and want to return this order. We want to confirm the user that the user have actually want to return this order or click this button by mistake. Okay, so before that there is one more check we are going to add for the product. Okay, that the user have selected the product or not, and for that we are going to have that, I think we have already added this return product. Okay, so here we are going to have the return product ID and its value. We are going to pick its value and we are going to check if product equal to empty, then we are again going to alert the user that please select which product you want to return. So it is mandatory to select the product as well. Return false. Okay, fine. Now we can try once here, click on return order. Here click on return order once again, click select reason for canceling the order. Okay, so it is asking to check that reason, but before that we want to have this check as well. Return product, if product is equal to empty, so we need to check here that return product is fine. Select name, return product. Okay, so let me check this one. Please select reason for canceling the order. Here I think it is showing, I think some button. I think we have updated everything. Make sure do it cancel. See, here we are required to give button return order. Okay, so that's why it is happening. So now we are going to refresh again and we'll click on return order. Return, please select which product you want to return. Now it is fine. We will select the product. Now click on return order again. Please select reason for turning the order. See, we will select now we will want to return this order. So if we will do cancel, nothing will happen. Okay, and if you will click return order again, want to return this order, if you will click OK this time, then it will move forward and it will go to this URL. Okay, so this URL we have not created so far. So we are going to create one route in web.php file for the return, like user order return. So it is similar to return like cancel. Okay, so route here match once again. We are going to add that similar kind of route get post, both will come here, and after that orders ID, and after that here return will come. Here we are going to have that orders controller order return, fine, like this. So in order return we are going to create this function inside orders controller similar to order cancel. So here we are going to create that function, public function order return, and here also we will have that dollar ID and the values from the form return request will come up here. And here we will again will have that post method. We are going to check the post method here, if dollar request is method post, okay, then we will pick everything in dollar data dollar request all, fine. Then see, we will print once all the data here to check whether the all required data is coming up in function or not. So we need to debug whatever we do, okay, and also we can check dollar ID as well, that we are having the that ID of the order ID is required. So that thing also we need to return here, okay. So let's go back once again, refresh. There is some syntax error comes up, okay. So need to make sure once, where is the syntax error? Return request, see, it is similar to that one. So dollar request is method post, dollar data request all, we are going to echo, okay. So here it seems to be fine. What it says, just check unexpected return expecting variable, okay, return dollar request, okay. So the mistake is I have wrongly mentioned here return, it will come request, okay. So silly mistake. So now see, now we are going to click on return here medium. So we will select something, test return order, want to return this order, okay. You can see all the data is coming here along with the order ID, okay, and all the data required data is coming here as well, okay. So here you can see that we able to show up the return. So we need to check the order ID is fine. So see, this one is the order ID 71th ID, okay, and we are going to return one of the item here, and the our return item is the BT01 medium, BT01 medium, okay. So this is the blue casual t-shirt we want to return, customer want to return, okay. So the request is coming here correctly. So in next video we are going to move forward, we are going to make this request and we'll add the entry here in the return request. Earlier on we have created the entry with the seeder, now we are going to dynamically create this entry whenever user makes the return request, and also we are going to update the order products table so that we can identify that which of the product is getting returned, is a return request initiated, something like that. So we will continue in next video, so please stay tuned for that, and we are going to finish this return process very soon, and we will start working on the exchange process as well, similar to Amazon, okay. So once you will complete everything, cancel, return and exchange, you will become you can do your Laravel projects in a complete, this is the complete Laravel e-commerce website. So this is mandatory now, every e-commerce website going to have the cancel, return and exchange process. Okay, in basic e-commerce series we have not done, but in advanced e-commerce series we are doing this one, and do follow this one. Okay, so we will continue in next video, stay tuned for that. That's all for now, have a nice time, goodbye.